Hey guys, it's Tekosor, and in today's video, I'll guide you through the installation process of PALWORLD FSR Mod made by LukeFZ and share some benchmarks on the ROG ALLY and the Legion Go. And we'll also see some various mods and optimization settings I found online that are made for an increasing performance and improved image quality. I'll be listing all links in the video description if you are interested to try them out. With that being said, let's get started first with the FSR mod. Before that, this video is sponsored by Keysfan. Keysfan is an online marketplace full of incredible deals, especially if you are in the market for a genuine Windows 11 or Office keys. Looking to get Windows 10 or 11 without breaking the bank? Check out Keysfan New Year Sale, where they offer genuine OEM keys at surprisingly affordable prices. Here is a quick guide on snagging those deals. Say you want Windows 11 Pro, simply add it to your cart, use a coupon code LOW50. This code slashes your price in half, that's 50% off. But wait, it gets even better. Interested in Office 2021 as well? Use the code LOW62 for an incredible 62% discount. And the ultimate saving you can get is with this bundle that includes both Windows 11 Pro and Office 2021 for only $37 or euros, which is also a whopping 62% discount. Payment options available are via PayPal or credit card. So if you are looking to get legit Microsoft product keys for your PC, as well as other softwares or game keys, Keysfan has got you covered with affordable and legal options. You can find all discounts and links in the description down below, and big thanks to Keysfan for being Tekosor first sponsor. Now back to our video. An important thing to note that as of now, the FSR mod seems to work only with the Steam version of PALWORLD. Instead, the Xbox Game Pass version still has anti-aliasing support, so hopefully once they get it released also there, the mod will work. And also, this is a paid mod, so you'll need to become a member of Luke Patreon page to have access to download it. Here I have the two necessary ones for PALWORLD, and the way to set it up is by doing the following. Open the FSR2 FSR3 underscore common folder and copy all files inside to where you have the game located. So for the Steam version, go to Steam, Steam Apps, Common, PALWORLD, PAL, Binaries, and finally Win64, and then paste them all here. The next step, go to FSR2 FSR3 underscore 220 folder and copy this file to the same game pass in the Win64 folder. Now open the optional MVNGX folder and run the enable signature override registry key. In order to trick the game engine to think we actually got an NVIDIA RTX GPU instead of our AMD iGPU. Now just launch the game for once and exit. Now it should create this config file, so just open it by using the notepad, and here we'll need to edit some lines. Set the fake NVIDIA GPU equal to true, and AMD Unreal Engine DLSS workaround from false to true as well. Save and exit. In Steam, right click on the game and go to properties and write this line -dx12, and that's it. Let's now test it out. Now we get in the graphics settings, DLSS being activated, and you can use all upscaling modes freely with frame generation. And now let's watch some benchmarks on the ALLY and the Legion Go.
Thank you.
Something I want to mention, if you are getting ghosting issues with the mod, just make sure to use TAA for anti-aliasing with DLSS on. For me, it's by far the best experience I've got on this game. As you can see, we got a good uplift and it works for both the Ally and the Legion Go while even reducing frame time. So I totally recommend giving this mod a try. It's definitely the best and very easy to set up as you saw. Also, he keeps updating it, so keep an eye on his Discord server. In addition to that mod, I have found in Reddit this post with bunch of Unreal Engine graphics settings modifications. For example, it has ones for DLSS, TAA, Ultra Graphics Plus, Cartoonify, and even Potato mode, and you can combine some of them as well. To set them up, go to your user folder and make sure to have hidden items shown by toggling it in the view. Then go to App Data, Local, PAL, Save, Config, and finally Windows. And here you should find Engine.ini file. First, before tweaking, make sure to make a copy of that default one should you need to restore settings. Now to make changes, open it in the notepad. Here we can see different configs used to how the game is rendered, so don't delete these ones. Instead, we'll do our changes right at the bottom. For a start, I'll copy those universal ones as the original poster said to use them as base settings. I'll also copy the DLSS ones. Also, make sure to not repeat the line saying script engine render settings since we have it already in the universal one. So once you are done, just save it like so, and that's it. Something I noticed though, that when I paste the TAA ones, it would break the frame generation mode. As you can see, we have so much ghosting going on with it. Without that TAA part, the game is totally fine, and I also felt some improvement, especially adding some sharpness. Now I was also curious to try out the Cartoonify preset, and it honestly looks a bit odd. Like the trees become without leaves and there's zero texture applied. Also surprisingly, I didn't feel so much FPS increase. I also tested various mods found in Nexus mods, and I'll start first with this one called Improved Anti-Aliasing by Hybrid. Inside you will find different presets. I'll go ahead and use the anti-ghosting preset for DLSS. To apply it, just copy the pack file and paste it in the packs folder found in the game directory here. But since we didn't have any ghosting prior, so I'm not sure what would actually change here. I also applied the included sharpness preset, and instead this one gives much sharper image. It seems quite useful to avoid blurriness, especially for the case with DLSS performance mode. And now onto the next mod we have, which is called Improved Graphics, also by Hybrid. And here you will find 3 presets, with the highly improved one being focused on improving the game image quality higher than the game default epic preset, while the lightly improved one also being higher than the game default epic, while also being focused on performance. And there's also a reshade preset that we'll try in a bit as well. So to use this mod, just select the preset you want. In my case, I'll use the DLSS one. Just like the previous one, copy the file and put it in the game pack folder. And this is the difference between the 3 mods. As you can see, there is some performance impact between each of them. To install the reshade preset, just download the reshade installer and run it. Select the game and choose DX12. Now navigate to where we have the mod located, and here I'll choose the enhanced preset. Check all the boxes here, and once it's done, in-game press the home button on your keyboard to open the reshade menu, where you can choose different effects such as color grading, blur, comic, etc. You can choose the ones to your liking, and usually they have small to tiny performance impact. Now you probably have noticed the occasional stutters we are getting in PALWORLD. And this mod by Hybrid is claiming to fix stutters and improving frame times and FPS as well. Inside we'll find the 3 presets, which are weak, decent, and strongest. You can just copy the packs file to the game directory like we done before, but honestly I still get stutters. I'm not sure if it's working on other devices, but on both my Ally and Legion Go, it's still stuttering with this mod. Now the next interesting mod I found is this one called Enable HDR Rendering and Display by Auburn, and you can install it by pasting the engine.ini file in the app data folder like we done with the optimization settings before. But unfortunately for me it didn't work. All I see in game is this black screen. That's because according to the mod creator, this one requires a native HDR display, otherwise you will see this black screen. So in our case, probably this mod won't work unless you connect an HDR external display. It's worth checking if you currently have one. And the final mod we have is this one called Enhanced PALWORLD Visuals by Francis Lewis. It's easy to set up, just copy the pack file to the game directory like the previous ones, but as you can see, FPS went down to as low as 15, so it's totally heavy to run for the Ally and the Legion Go, just going to impact the performance significantly. And that brings us to the end of this video. I'm curious to know which mods you have been using for PALWORLD, perhaps I can give them a try. So even though some mods I tried didn't give us a positive effect now, they are still all worth keeping an eye on for future update. I would like next to try making optimized settings for both the Ally and the Legion Go by using the Engine.ini file. We also make use of some reshades that will enhance image while not impacting performance. Please let me know if you would like to see that. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to TechoSword to be updated on future videos. If you got any issues applying any of those mods, please feel free to write in the comment section or ask over at our Discord server. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one.